There was an initial stability that we saw coming into the rupee markets. But since then, the rupee markets have shown a considerable amount of depreciation against the US dollar. And the market at this point in time had two fears. One, would the RBI be forced to take further monetary measures to step in this slide on the rupee side? And two, the widening current account deficit that everyone has been talking about in line with the Fed QE. The fact that if QE triggers were to be as time-bound as the market was expecting, which is starting September, the current account deficit problem would not have gone away, would have continued to put pressure on the currency, and might have forced the RBI to take further punitive steps. So that was the immediate reason for the further negative reaction that we have seen in the market in the last 7-15 days. Current account deficit has been a big issue, but more than the current account deficit in itself, the market has been more worried at this point in time with the funding of the current account deficit. From a market perspective, I think on the current account side especially, we would need to see some further measures being taken to reduce the demand side. See, the fixed income markets would not wait for the RBI action per se to stabilize and start rallying. I think the immediate point would be stability on the macro front, primarily stability on the currency front at this point in time. People would be very closely watching as to where the spot and forwards finally settle down. And finally, over the next 2 to 3 months, people would be looking at the trade and current account deficit numbers very closely to see whether the issue that we have on the rupee is getting addressed on a priority basis or not. Between now and September end, we think that markets will continue to be volatile. Considering all these things, I think the basic message here is that currently the absolute levels in the markets remain very, very attractive for investors to invest in. But investors have to come in with a slightly longer term time horizon here, because volatility over the next 2 to 3 months can be very high. So investors need to come in with a very well defined holding period horizon when they are investing in any debt fund. In fact, if at all, the holding period horizon should be as long as possible, so that the near term volatility does not really force investors to take any kind of wrong decisions midway.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme related documents carefully.